network is 1.8 billion account holders who can transact and over 30 million merchants and a million ATMs.
With that kind of volume, the speed is critical. We've got a lot of transactions that clock in at a third of a second. Basically, it takes longer for a clerk to swipe the card than it does to go out and back 6,000-mile round trip.
The promise of Visa is that we provide the reliability, the security, the payment guarantee for every single one of those transactions. Behind that promise is the network.
It's got to be routinely flawless. VisaNet, the network, has got to be like a light switch, like electricity, like water.
And everybody knows what 1 second of outage time would mean to a consumer, to a merchant. It's prime time somewhere in the world, and we have to keep the systems running all the time.
We wake up with that in mind, and we go to bed with that in mind. It's a 24/7 job to make sure that it processes flawlessly.
And it's so important when we're talking about money, right, about people's lives.
There are billions of transactions running through our gateway. Every transaction has a story.
If you think about VisaNet and the number of individuals that it touches every day, the best opportunity that we have for the future is to be able to take that raw capability and push it into some of the new emerging channels, whether that's mobile or e-commerce.
That's a major difference compared to what other people are looking at in terms of just trying to build a payment system that can just get transactions from point A to point B. We really are tearing apart those transactions and adding some real logic to that part of the payment system.
The value of that data in the network and the services is very, very difficult to replicate on the scale and the precision that VisaNet has.
We just scratched the surface. We have a larger field to conquer.
There are a billion people today who are not co-opted to the formal financial system. I really believe we have the potential to bring financial services to a huge chunk of the world's population, and if we can achieve a portion of that goal, then we will have done something good, not just for those consumers, but for economies at large, and that's where we're headed.